Hi, Nana.
We were learning about question bank related to study of first element hydrogen.
Okay, study of first element hydrogen.
So we will continue with the 18th question. What is 18th question?
Arrange the following metals in the order in which they appear in the activity series. So there are certain metals given. Okay, we have to arrange these metals in the activity series. See how they appear in the activity metals, how they appear in activity series. So we have to arrange these metals in that order. So copper, what are the given metals? Copper, calcium. What are the given metals? Copper, calcium, aluminum, iron, sorry, magnesium, lead, sodium and zinc are given. So we have to arrange them in the order. Okay, so what is the order of what is the order of these elements in the activity series? So out of these elements, which element will come first? So sodium. Sodium is highly reactive. So sodium will come first. Which element? Sodium. Sodium. See here, these elements are given. So we have to put down the most reactive metal first. Most reactive metal first and least reactive metal last. So out of all this, so what is the most reactive metal? Sodium. Okay, and the least reactive metal among these is copper. Okay, copper. We have to keep copper at the end. So next to sodium, the more reactive metal is calcium. Okay, and next to calcium is magnesium. And next to magnesium in the given metals is aluminium. And next to aluminium, the reactivity is zinc, more reactive metal. Okay, next to zinc, the more reactive metal is iron. And next to iron, the more reactive metal is lead. Okay, so like this, we have to arrange the given elements in an order which appear in the activity series. So in the activity series, these metals appear in this order only. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So all metals are covered. So this is the order. So this is the answer for this question. So here, arrange the following metals. So these metals were given and we have to arrange in the order in which they appear in the activity series. Okay, and these are the given metals. And we have to put down the most reactive metal first and least reactive metal last. So this is the answer to the first question. See, in 18th question, there are two sub-questions. Sub-question A, the question related to sub-question A is this one. And answer to that one is this. Now we will learn about the sub-question B. What is sub-question B of 18th question? Sub-question B of 18th question. Sub-question B related to 18th question. So sub-question B, it is very lengthy question. So here in this sub-question, P, Q, R, okay, are the coded letters. P, Q are the coded letters. Coded letters. So to what it is, these are the codes. So these are the coded letters of Okay, these are the coded letters of 3 metals. These are the coded letters for 3 metals, it seems. 3 metals. Okay, in the activity series, 3 metals in the activity series, in the activity series given in A above. That means this question B, okay, this is related to question A also. Okay, so here in question A, so this is the answer to the question A. So this question B is related to question A. Okay, so what is that question A? So it is related, question A answer is this one. So here P, Q and R are the coded letters for 3 metals. So there are 3 metals out of all these metals. So there are 3 metals. For those 3 metals, P, Q and R are the coded letters. Okay, so what are those 3 metals? We have to identify. So P, Q, R are the coded letters for 3 metals in the activity series given in A above. Above means already we have erased that one. Okay, we have rubbed that one. So now the metal P, the metal P, so P, so this is P. So P is one metal out of all these metals. P is one metal, Q is another metal, and R is another metal. So here the metal P reacts violently with cold water. The metal P reacts violently with cold water. So out of all these metals, which metal react with cold water? Only sodium and calcium reacts with cold water. And which metal will react violently with cold water? Only sodium will react violently with cold water. Calcium does not react violently with cold water. So calcium will react with cold water, but not violently. But sodium will react violently with cold water. So from this it is understood that P is nothing but sodium. So from this it is understood that P is nothing but metal sodium. Next. So the metal P reacts. So this is the part of the question only. The metal P reacts violently with cold water. Okay. Cold water. And it's a hydroxide. And it's a hydroxide. It's a hydroxide. And its hydroxide is not decomposed. Is not decomposed by heat. By heat. Generally, see, look here. The sodium hydroxide, if you heat sodium hydroxide, what happens? It does not decompose into sodium oxide and hydrogen gas. It does not decompose. This does not happen. Whereas with all other metals, this thing takes place. With all other metals, this one takes place. Okay, sodium and calcium, so they do not decompose like this. But from magnesium onwards, what happens? All these metals, their hydroxides. For example, if you take magnesium hydroxide and if you heat this magnesium hydroxide slightly, then it will break down into magnesium oxide and hydrogen gas is liberated. If you take aluminium, if you heat aluminium hydroxide strongly, if you heat aluminium hydroxide strongly, see, magnesium hydroxide upon heating slightly also, it will break down, it will decompose. But from aluminium onwards, we have to heat them strongly. So upon heating strongly, what happens? They will decompose and forms their oxides and liberates hydrogen gas. Okay, so here the question is, the metal P reacts violently with cold water. So from this it is understood that it is sodium and it's a hydroxide. It's hydroxide means sodium hydroxide is not decomposed by heat. So anyhow, we know that sodium hydroxide, it is not decomposed. It is not broken down like this upon heating. Okay, so this reaction does not take place. If you heat this sodium hydroxide, this reaction does not take place. That means the sodium hydroxide does not decompose into sodium oxide and hydrogen. Okay, so from this it is understood, clearly it is understood that the metal P is nothing but, metal P is nothing but sodium metal. Okay, right. Next, it is not decomposed by heat. So next, metal Q. So now about metal Q. Okay, metal Q has no reaction. Metal Q has no reaction. Metal Q has no reaction with water. With water. That means, so metal Q does not have no reaction. So that means, so these two metals will have reaction with water. But these metals, they do not react with water. They react with steam, not with water. These two metals, they react with water. But from magnesium onwards, they do not react with water. They react with steam. Okay. Water in the form of steam. Okay. So here the question is, metal Q has no reaction with water. But it's hydroxide. But its hydroxide decomposes on slight warming. So that means, so that metal Q, it is one out of all these metals, and it is clearly understood that the metal Q, its hydroxide decomposes on slight warming. So which metal will decompose on slight warming? Magnesium hydroxide. Already we learned magnesium hydroxide upon slight warming also it will decompose into magnesium oxide and hydrogen gas. Okay, so the question is, the metal Q has no reaction with water. See, magnesium does not react with water. It will react with boiling water, or else it will react with steam. And that same metal and its hydroxide decomposes on slight warming. So from this it is understood that the metal Q is nothing but magnesium. Okay. Hydroxide, okay, on slight warming giving a powder. So actually this is ash, this is a white powder, white color powder. So slight warming giving a powder. So from here to here it is understood that the metal Q is nothing but magnesium. Metal Q is nothing but what? Magnesium. Okay. Next. So what is the continuation of this question? So this question is very lengthy. Okay. Continuation. We'll see the continuation of this question. Right. So what are the given metals in the question A? So sodium, calcium, magnesium, aluminium, zinc, iron, okay, lead and copper were given. Okay, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, right. So these metals were given in the first question. So based on this question only, based on these elements only, the 18th B is framed. So P, Q, R. So this is P, this is Q, and now we have to find the R. Next, metal R reacts very fastly with cold dilute hydrochloric acid dilute hydrochloric acid. Hydrochloric acid means HCl. Okay, but hardly at all with cold water. But hardly at all with cold water. With cold water. So now already we know that this is metal P and this is metal Q. So next one, the metal R reacts. So what is R? So metal R, it is not calcium, because so here with calcium the metal will calcium, it is a highly reactive metal. So highly reactive metal, generally they are not made to react with the acids, because the reaction may be sometimes explosive. So that is so here we can exclude calcium. Okay, now these are the metals to be considered. So that means metal R may be one out of all these. So, and it is given that with cold dilute HCl, that metal R reacts vigorously, and also but hardly at all with cold water. That means it does not react with cold water. So calcium will react with cold water. Hence we can easily eliminate that. So it is clearly understood that calcium is not metal R, because that metal R hardly react with cold water, but hardly at all with cold water. That means this metal reacts hardly with cold water, but calcium can easily react with cold water. So that means from this statement it is understood that metal R is not calcium. So, and it may be any one out of these metals. And in order to know which metal it is, so here the question is continued like this. If steam is passed over white hot solid, okay, or white hot solid R. So I mean about R, the metal, about the metal R. Okay, another white solid. Okay, and another white solid. Okay, A is formed. So that means metal R. So here actually white, that metal when R is heated, it is white hot. Okay, when R is heated to white hot, and onto this R, if steam is passed, onto this R, if steam is passed, what is happened? So another white solid A is formed. Another white solid A is formed. So that means this is white solid R, metal R is a white solid when it is hot. Okay, and when steam is passed over this hot white solid R, so another white solid is formed. Okay, and another white solid is formed, and a colorless gas is set free, and a colorless gas is set free. See, generally what might be the colorless gas B is set free. So that means a gas B is formed which is colorless. So from this statement it is understood that first we have to write like this. In order to know correct things, we have to write like this. So generally it is understood that metal when reacts with steam, the gas liberated, when metal reacts with steam, the gas, if at all a gas is liberated, that gas is nothing but hydrogen gas. And it is clearly mentioned that it is a colorless gas. Okay, so hydrogen gas is colorless gas. Whenever metal reacts with steam, so the only gas which is liberated is hydrogen gas only. So from this it is understood that gas B. So gas B is nothing but what? Gas B is nothing but H2 gas. Gas B is nothing but H2 gas. So from this it is understood clearly that gas B is nothing but H2 gas. And solid A. What is solid A? What is solid A? So now look here. So this is zinc. This zinc will be white solid. Okay. It will be white solid, white hot solid. So aluminum and all these are different different solids. So they have different colors. But zinc is a white solid. So when zinc, suppose if it is zinc only, it will be white in color upon hot. Okay, upon hot. White hot solid. If you heat this zinc to white hot, and steam is passed over this zinc, what happens? It forms a zinc oxide. It forms a zinc oxide, which is also white in color. Which is also white in color. Okay, so from this it is understood. So this is the part of the question. So this is a paragraph. Based on this paragraph, some more questions are given. Okay, some more questions are given. So we have to answer those questions. So from this it is understood that A is nothing but zinc oxide. A is nothing but what? A is nothing but zinc oxide. Hence R is nothing but zinc. Okay, R is nothing but zinc. So with the help of all this information, we can finally conclude that P is nothing but sodium, Q is nothing but magnesium, and R is nothing but zinc, and A is nothing but zinc oxide, and B is nothing but hydrogen gas. Okay, so now based on this information, so some questions were given related to B, question B of 18th question. So now we will see what are the given questions in the question B. Sub questions are given. So we will look into those sub questions. Sub question 1 of 18th B. What is the question? Which metals in the list are P, Q and R? Which metals in the list are P, Q and R? So already so from that information we came to know that P is sodium, Q is magnesium and R is zinc. So what is the answer to this question? Which metals in the list are P, Q, R? So P is what? Sodium. Okay, Q is nothing but magnesium. And R is nothing but zinc. Next. Sub question 2. What is sub question 2? If A and B are codes for substances. If A and B are the codes for substances. For solid A, so code is given as A, and gas B, and for gas B, the code is given as B. Okay, so identify them. So from the given information in the paragraph. So from that paragraph we came to know that A is nothing but zinc oxide. So what is the answer for this question? A is nothing but zinc oxide, and B is nothing but hydrogen gas. Because whenever metal reacts with steam, it liberates the only gas. What is that gas? Hydrogen gas. Okay, as it is white hot metal and forms a white solid. So that means when zinc is heated to white hot, and steam is passed on to this one. It forms a, finally it forms a white solid zinc oxide. See, zinc oxide actually it is yellow, it is yellow when hot, but it becomes white when it is cool. Okay, so in the question it is mentioned as white solid. So we have to think that finally it is converted into white solid. So what is that white solid? It is zinc oxide. Okay, so that means this is A and this is B. So A is nothing but zinc oxide and B is nothing but hydrogen. So like this question can be, I mean 18th question can be answered, and the second question of 18th B question is like this. Next, third question. So state what would you observe, state what would you observe, state what would you observe, what would be your observation, sorry, state what would be your observation, your state what would be your observations, and write chemical equations and write chemical equations when nitrates of P and Q are heated strongly. So what would be your observations, and write chemical equations when nitrates of P and Q are heated strongly. So P is nothing but sodium. So sodium nitrate, if you heat sodium nitrate, what happens? Always remember that sodium nitrate or potassium nitrate, when heated, the solid form of sodium or potassium nitrate will convert into liquid form initially. It will melt sodium or potassium nitrate first. It will melt and converts into liquid form initially. Upon further heating, what happens? So the sodium nitrate will convert into sodium nitrite. Okay, sodium nitrite, and oxygen gas is liberated. In the same way, even potassium also will behave like this only and forms potassium nitrite. Potassium nitrate and oxygen gas is liberated. So here in the question, so potassium nitrate or potassium thing is not given, but for your end of for your knowledge, I am giving you this one also, because sodium nitrate and potassium nitrate behaves similarly. Both sodium nitrate and potassium nitrates, both of these, they behave similarly. So here I am rubbing potassium nitrate because it is not given in the question. Okay, for your knowledge purpose, I have given this one up. Okay, so this observation we can find. So what is the chemical equation? So I can write this chemical equation like this. So as it is mentioned to write only chemical equation, so no need of writing this one and this one again. Okay, simply I will write the chemical equation like this. Sodium nitrate upon heating, what happens? So it will break down. Initially, the solid will convert into liquid, and then only it will break down into sodium nitrite and oxygen gas. So upon balancing, finally we'll get like this. Okay, so that means nitrate of P, this is nitrate of P. So already we know that P is sodium. So, nitrate of P is nothing but sodium nitrate. Sodium nitrate upon heating, what happens?
sodium nitrate, the solid form of sodium nitrate, initially it will melt and convert into liquid form of sodium nitrate, and upon further heating it will decompose into sodium nitrite. Sodium nitrate will convert into sodium nitrite, okay, and oxygen gas is liberated. Now, nitrite of Q, what happens to nitrite of Q? What is Q? Magnesium. So, magnesium nitrite, nitrite of Q is nothing but magnesium nitrite. See, all other nitrites, magnesium nitrate, nitrate of Q is nothing but magnesium nitrate. See, all other nitrates, this is solid, it does not melt, okay. This solid, it does not melt and it will directly convert, it will directly decompose. But sodium nitrate and potassium nitrate, they initially melt and then only they will decompose like this. But here in this case what happens? They do not melt and they directly decompose and they decompose into their oxides. Okay, all other nitrates, they decompose into oxides. Whereas sodium and potassium, they will decompose into nitrites. But other nitrates, upon heating, okay, they decompose into oxide. Nitrogen dioxide gas is liberated, and even oxygen gas is also liberated. So this is most important. So be careful, practice well. Okay, so here upon balancing, we'll get the balanced equation, 4NO2 plus oxygen. See, so sodium and potassium, sodium and potassium nitrates will convert into nitrites, but all other nitrates they will decompose into their oxides, and they liberate NO2 gas and oxygen gas. The color of NO2 gas is reddish brown, so this is also important. So all other nitrates upon heating, they decompose and liberate a reddish brown colored gas. But sodium nitrate or potassium nitrate, they do not liberate this gas, reddish brown colored gas. Okay, except sodium nitrate and potassium nitrate, all other nitrates will produce reddish brown colored gas known as reddish brown colored gas known as nitrogen dioxide gas. Okay, so this is the observation. So here, this is the observation, and this is the chemical equation for when nitrates of P and nitrates of Q are strongly heated. Okay, next one is, one more question is given in the 18th sub question B. Okay, 18th sub question B. So what is the another sub question? Fourth sub question. Amongst the hydroxides of P and Q, okay, state which is soluble? State which is state which is soluble and which is insoluble, and which is insoluble. Okay, see, remember, so how to answer this question? Always remember that hydroxides of sodium, potassium and ammonium. Okay, see, remember, so these are soluble in water. That means
sodium hydroxide, potassium hydroxide and ammonium hydroxide. They are soluble in water.
But all other hydroxides are insoluble in water.
So take it as a grant. Okay. So that means all other hydroxides are insoluble. All other hydroxides are insoluble in water. Insoluble in water. So P is what? Sodium. So that means sodium hydroxide. Sodium hydroxide is soluble in water. So among the hydroxides of P and Q, state which is soluble and which is insoluble. So that means P hydroxide. Hydroxide related to P is soluble in water. And hydroxide related to Q. What is Q? Q is magnesium. So only these hydroxides are soluble in water in the nature. Okay, all other hydroxides may be calcium hydroxide or maybe magnesium hydroxide, maybe aluminium hydroxide, maybe zinc hydroxide or else any hydroxide, etc. All other hydroxides, they are insoluble in water. Okay, so from this, so how to answer this question? So in order to answer this question, so we have to know this basic information. So we have to have this knowledge. Unless until we have this knowledge, we cannot answer to such questions. Okay, always remember that. So take it grant. Okay, so fix it in your mind that forever we have to fix it in our mind. Hydroxides of only these three are soluble in water and hydroxides of all other remaining, all other hydroxides are insoluble in water. So that means, so hydroxide of Q is nothing but magnesium hydroxide. It is insoluble. Hydroxide of P is nothing but sodium hydroxide. It is soluble in water. Okay, right. So now with this question 18th is finished. It's a very lengthy question. Okay, we have covered only 18th question in this session. So in the next video, we'll continue with the other questions. Okay, no. Bye.